It's Ford FS1 College Hoops tip-off. It's right now, and it's sponsored by Ford. Going further, so you can. Capacity crowd of 10,000 plus on hand in Providence, Rhode Island. We're at the dunk, and we may see some dunks before it's all over. The Gavitt tip-off is underway. Minnesota comes a-calling. Big Ten versus Big East. And my old friend Bill Raftery, it's like spring has sprung when I'm with you. And we're here in Providence, so where fitting. It all began with David.
Actually, the great respect Cincinnati had for Dave Gavitt. That's why this takes place. These two great conferences, so competitive. I'm delighted, not only for the town, but for what Dave has meant to basketball.
This is a Providence team that's gone to, for the first time, four straight NCAAs. They're loaded, though, just outside the top 25. And what a job Richard Pitino's done.
Unbelievable. Because the returning five starters, which certainly helps you. They pounded in. They're great inside. Of course, Providence, some young people, a couple old guys. They like to get up and down.
A couple of old guys here to call the game for you here tonight as you look at those starting lineups. Keep an eye on Nate Mason. He is the big-time go-to guy. And, of course, Rodney Bullock leads the way for this Providence team that brings back 95% of its offense. No other team in the country can say that. They are considered one of the favorites without question in the Big East Conference. And the great friendship spawned, as was mentioned, between Delaney, the commissioner of the Big Ten, and Dave Gavitt when he began the Big East back in the decade of the 80s. It's almost nostalgic whenever you come into this building, especially now to tip off the college season right here on FS1.
And we'll have
a little mulligan.
Exactly.
Get the season going.
I like Scirato with a little miscue earlier.
Get it up there, Scirato. DJ Carstensen along with Paul Sales, the rest of the officiating crew.
And right now, Timmy B, the Providence Friars go with a little bit.
Now we can begin the season.
And you got to watch the monitor because the fans don't sit to the score.
That's right.
Side to side, pounded in on occasion. The two bigs, Lynch and Murphy. It's a nice look.
Knocked away by Jackson. He was the last to touch it. It'll be controlled underneath. Our Keys to Success, sponsored by SoFi, offering smart solutions to help you reach your financial goals.
They get it inside to those big fellas. Can help Minnesota press, push, gets a little walk in the backcourt here.
Yep.
As they force Mason to put it on the deck.
This youngster, Nate Mason, now a senior, one of the leaders for this team. He's done a lot to change what his reputation was a couple of years ago. Had a magnificent close to the season for Minnesota. Hands off to Cartwright, loves to go to his left. That's Young.
That's what he does.
Boy, that was some dime he dropped. And they finally sit down and we can see again.
Exactly. Nice hands on the catch as well. You got to do your homework early on the bigs. Lead them to the post area. A lot of high five ball screens. Nice split.
Amir Coffey from downtown.
There's where you're in trouble.
Lynch. Boy, look at the strength he's got.
He carves out so much area, you really have to stick him and stick him early.
Cartwright gets his motor running. Look out. Providence wants to push it. Minnesota, a team that really thrives on its defense. Cartwright off the back iron. Pulled down by Jordan Murphy. The size on Murphy. He's a matchup problem. Yes, and a foul.
Boy, he hung tough with that, didn't he? They got a piece of it. That's what makes him tough. He can step out a little bit. You got to play him, and you got the duck in ability of Lynch. Now watch this recovery here. This is pretty darn good.
Yeah.
He really stuck with it.
Khalif Young got the foul, his first. By the way, in talking today with Ed Cooley at the walkthrough today, he was concerned about Emmett Holt not being available because this kid is a matchup problem for him without Holt.
Right, and he gets people in foul problems too. Ooh, they do this great in the backcourt. Wes Unsell. And Mason really has got to count the chicklets too.
Diallo could not get that one to go. It rolls off and Murphy gets it back into the hands of the leader, McGruber. This is a Minnesota offense that doesn't necessarily have off guards and points. It's just a three-guard set and a beautiful runner right there, Bill, by Nate Mason.
Yeah, he can break it down, no question about it. Great leadership qualities, unselfish, and they can provide a lift on occasion.
Seven unanswered after the first hoop.
Here's the little flex we saw today at practice. Try and get the big guys away from the basket a little bit. Make you work defensively. It's punishing. Get it under 10, control the tempo a little bit.
There's Bullock, rejected. That's great defensive work by Murphy.
Nice run, look at the spread.
Again, they quickly double-team Murphy as he got it on the block.
Well, you gotta be quick to play this game anymore. Oh, good handle.
You don't understand how physical Minnesota is. You're gonna find out tonight. Fall away, that's not there. Ill-advised shot.
Great balance defensively by Minnesota. Nice run here, though. Diallo. He is a promising player. Ability to give it up nicely by Cartwright.
35 years old, Richard Pitino, as a head coach in this building for the first time, was an assistant here. Mm-hmm. And of course, this is his alma mater.
Well known in these parts. It's a great name. 87. Then he took him to the promised land.
30 years ago, hard to believe it's been that long.
Steps.
Young Steps, you're right, prior to the shot. Ed Cooley, what I love about this guy is an assistant at Boston College, as everyone knows. This is his dream job. He loves it here.
A great judge of talent as well. He's put together a good group. This is a very promising year for him. I think they're going to get better. Young people are going to improve as the year progresses.
He had a top 15 recruiting class
nice pass
last year. Lynch with the dunk.
How about that look? That's your 6'9", 6'10", making the delivery there.
That Murph. Was Murph with a beautiful delivery, and it's now a 9-0 run after that first deuce for Providence in the opening sequence.
Baseline bumps, ball reversal, nice look.
That's where you want it. Bullock off the back rim, Lynch. Quickly retrieves it into Mason's hands.
Yeah, they really look a tough shot there. You know, he can do it.
Nothing but nylon.
Yeah, what a start. On the road, you gotta feel good.
PC is 0 for their last 5. Meanwhile, Mason gets the job done. And a dozen straight. How about this dish?
Richard Pitino knows all the good Italian restaurants and all the good players. Big to big. Send it in, big fella. Lynch. Rising big time.
Big East College Hoops on FS1 is sponsored by Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Go Friars, go
Golden Gophers out to a scintillating start and lead it by 10 in a quick timeout prior to the TV timeout. Position, which would be only 5 seconds from now, had to be taken by Ed Cooley. And right now, Murphy
and tough
and Mason have been outstanding. I think Reggie Lynch has been a problem for them too.
Not quite. Jordan Murphy really can do so many things. He can bounce, get in the lane, hesitate, make plays.
21 Jalen Lindsey on the floor. That's a guy that can get hot in a hurry. Here's Diallo.
Nice out of a nice call out of the timeout. Screen. Diallo gets the puppies organized and delivers it.
Well, that ended a 3-minute and 33-second drought for the Friars. Watson trying to get the job. That's the youngster that they're so high on. This kid is outstanding. Freshman from Arlington, Virginia. Among the biggest signees they've ever had here. He gets that foul.
Just a little cross screen. You can see he gets himself organized. Nice little set of the timeout. Got out of the flex. Lindsey on the floor can ring the bell too. The extra step. Buffy.
Lindsey helped bring that about defensively. We see the youngster just into the game, Isaiah Washington, freshman from Harlem, St. Raymond's High, already a legend from blacktop fame. And the big city. Keep an eye on him. Number 11 right now checking Diallo.
He's one of those guys that can beat you with the bounce late in the shot. Nice drive. Oh,
ooh,
goodness.
Beautiful.
A little flash.
Yeah.
And you said he only goes left. He's going to shock you before the night's over. He can go both ways this year. This kick can go to the hole.
Ooh, what a strong move that was by Jordan Murphy.
Boy, off the deck. I had said he's 6'9". That's with the hair as well. He's about 6'7", I think, but really strong and quick.
Kyron Cartwright would tell you, by the way, and here he is with the rock right now, that athletically he's left-handed, but in every other aspect, he's right-handed.
Nice find. Pretty.
Gonna get better at it, and that's the first of many that you'll see for Watson. And it's 14-8.
He does a nice job rolling from screens, heads up, sees the ball, catches it.
Mason again, that one's an air ball. Saved by Lynch, but into Lindsey's hands. Numbers for Cartwright, a pull-up. Ooh, he's fouled.
I thought he may have walked, by the way, or carried it there.
Little bunny hop.
We were hidden here as he got to the lane.
Amir Coffey gets the foul.
Let's see what he does here at the lane, though.
It
looked like he touched it, but he didn't.
Yeah.
Not bad.
It was a little spatter dribble.
That's what cameras are for.
Yeah. Cartwright, by the way, got to be the leader of this team. You think of Chris Dunn and what he meant to the Providence program. Kyron Cartwright became a star in his own right a year ago for this Providence team as they made their late season surge in the Big East.
Eddie said he's coming along. Eddie Cooley, that is. He really feels he's finding the total package now. The feel for the game, play on the ball, off the ball.
You know, no one ever called a right-hander crafty.
That's true.
High pick from Konate just came into the game. Bakari Konate, 21.
Inside player, more of a rebounder.
Washington can't hit it.
The top.
Good look, and an over-the-top foul.
Konate.
Yep. Bokari just into the game with his first.
How about the timeout to get yourself organized?
Yeah.
By Providence.
And by the way, he got Makai Ashton Langford into the game, the freshman from Worcester, Mass, by way of Brewster Academy. You're going to see a lightning quick three guard look from Providence through the course of this season that will be really fun to watch.
This kid plays with a great deal of maturity. Solid all around player. Nice post pass here.
Good block out again by Lynch. Well, PC had scored on their last four trips after that drop.
That is close.
Oh, what a move. Everything but the finish, Bill.
Donati's got to finish that deal, too.
Yep. Watson missed the dunk. He wanted the big play and couldn't come away with it.
Going at one another early here.
Man.
Nice dish.
Coffey.
Konate, that's his job.
Yeah. Fans love the hustle. And by the way, if Minnesota didn't know that much, if these Big Ten kids didn't know much about this environment, they're finding out now.
How about the footwork here? Unfortunately, they don't clean it up and finish it, but Murph with a great look. And at this end, just a little nudge. Competitive play around the rim.
They ruled it a tie. The alternating possession goes to Providence. I love that hustle that we saw right there.
By Ashton Langford, you mentioned that this kid really understands the game. He is going to be a solid performer all during the course of the year. Uses a ball screen well, does an awful lot of good things. Kick out threes. You can't turn it over against this team.
Looks like we got a player control foul that time. And it went against Makai Ashton Langford.
Automatic switch on the perimeter.
There's the dump down. It all starts right here with Lynch. Coffey. Lindsey comes down with a rebound for the Friars.
Got to get Coffey going right. They don't get back in time.
Here on the floor. The big guy can really run the floor.
How about the find as Richard Pitino calls timeout? Makai Ashton Langford. But when your bigs get down the floor and are acknowledged, you mentioned that timeout, Timmy, a 10-2 run after a timeout. He's young, fresh, and unabashed at the rim, huh?
Woo!
Send it in, big fella.
Just the fact that Coach Gavitt's name is on the game symbolizes excellence. And we should honor him a little bit more because I think he's bigger than the actual Gavitt games on what he did for the Big East, what he did for USA Basketball, and what he's done for the game in general. I don't want to call him Naismith, but he's right next to him.
And Ed would know, you know, he began his career as an assistant at UMass, then Dartmouth, Stonehill, Rhode Island, Boston College before becoming a head coach. And Joe Mullaney, bring back great memories
sure,
there, Bill.
Sure do. He was the assistant to Joe.
Yeah.
I lost to both guys, but we can say that in most buildings. But easy Ed has a great feel for the history of the game.
He's an old soul, a throwback.
A little zone look here. It looks like they may match up out of it.
Fitzgerald into the game for the first time, number 20.
And Washington can break you down on the dribble, too. Mention he can get his own shot. Look at this handle.
Oh, Washington, what a navigator he was. He made that happen. And he got it inside to Reggie Lynch.
Sleight of hand, the ability to maneuver in traffic, play with confidence. They were nice enough to send them tapes in the early exhibition games. He wowed people, struggled the last game. And how about using the rim here by Lynch? Mention the shoulders and the strength, turn the corner, understanding of where he is as well.
All New York guards from the Blacktops that were famous before they got out of high school. It's almost the ball is a part of the
strength.
Anatomy.
Pearl.
Yeah.
Right. Rod Strickland. Stephon.
Yep. Strickland's a great one from the past, no doubt about
nice
it.
Nice pump fake, and they do that well.
And uses the window.
They do that well.
That was a tremendous play. Well done by Ashton Langford.
A straight up man.
Mason, a scoop to the hoop, and he's fouled by White.
Well, what a great design, too. Empty the backside, hit and follow to the pinch post, the elbow area. But how about this pump? Put it on the deck with the left. A little kiss in downtown Providence. And at the other end, just well designed. You saw the clear out and the feel for the game, the floater. Mason.
He's on the watch list for the Naismith and the Bob Cousy Award, this kid. Preseason All Big Ten after becoming All Big Ten first team last year. You got to go back to Chris Humphreys 2004. Those great teams that they had at Minnesota. The last time a Big Ten All First Team Big Ten player was at Minnesota.
He really understands the game, too. Had a little smile there. I think he liked that delivery himself.
19-14. Golden Gophers lead it by five.
Automatic switch. They got a mismatch with Bullock if they use him.
There he is on the block.
He can elevate.
Shot clock down to 10. First time we've said that tonight.
He's got to elevate now. He's got the size. Tough shot there.
He passed up a good look earlier in that sequence, didn't he?
Yeah.
Sometimes that better look comes a little earlier in the clock.
I thought he could have kept the dribble and turned instead of kicking it to the wing. And they got a little conversation on the clock, maybe? Or
maybe. One thing that we need to watch for as the game goes on is because they're going to be really tough. They've got more room, the coaches, now to work with in the coaches' box, but they're going to strictly enforce
coming out on the floor.
And Richard was right on that line. And I think he was just asking for clarification on the clock.
See, in the old days, we used to cross one another. Louis would be at my bench. I would be at his.
Yeah.
Rolly would be running around.
Yeah, they could have penalized Rolly and Louis for a tire. Their shirt tails coming out through the course of the game. That's why Louis went to the sweater.
They worked it. Here's the zone now, I think. Yep, a little 2-3 with a match and a trap.
Off the back iron, it won't go for Mason. Lindsay!
There we go. And a nice give as well by Malik White. Plenty of time early for the knockdown.
Jalen Lindsay can score in bunches. And if he gets better at shooting off the bounce, he's got a future beyond college.
Hurt on the floor now, left nice high low.
Oh, beautiful, but Lynch missed the dunk. Young with the rebound, and he gives it back up. Lindsay again. This time a little too strong off the back end.
Boy, is this house alive, by the way.
Is it ever?
We are ready for this season. This is where he's tough. He's tough.
Ooh. I mean, the hang time there off the dribble drive by Isaiah Washington. Now you know why this kid's so highly thought of. Had a poor game against Upstate the other night at home. Maybe a little too juiced. Only 1 of 11 from the floor. But he is ready for prime time tonight. Young. Air ball taken out by Nate Mason.
Well, they put pressure on you to break that. Nice clean look. Hurt should have had that one.
Numbers aren't there, but White blows by.
These guards have the confidence to take people. A nice rotation in the backcourt. Here's a little blow for Cartwright. White comes out.
White, the sophomore from Richmond, Virginia. He's making a big jump this year. Minnesota by 2. And a reach-in foul against Ashton Langford.
I think that's number 2.
Yes, it is. That's number 2 on Ashton Langford.
How about Lindsay with the ability to get a little nylon from deep early? It lets the house know. And White, kid who can make threes, has that feel. Turn that shoulder and protect. Pretty smooth backcourt. Both sides.
That was the 16th foul, by the way. So one more. They're in the bonus. Minnesota will be shooting after this. Ashton Langford does get a second. Well, the PC starters have 8 of their points. Their bench, Bill, has accounted for 11 of the 19.
Here's that match now. A lot of finger pointing. Look at this kid dancing, knock it down.
Oh, he's in
he's
a groove.
Got a game. He really does.
Yes, he does.
It's one of his favorites. A little Timmy T toe-tapping.
We'll be headed to Studio 54 days in a moment. He keeps this up. He rattles home a tray.
Now that's going to open up the inside game a little. The bigs have to come out and contest.
23-22, first bucket for the leading man of this Providence Flyer team in 2017.
I think they can get their high-low if they're patient. There's the fill.
This kid's feeling it, Bill. He's feeling it. That's 3 field goals for him. And I get the feeling that every time he touches it, he's going to challenge whoever's checking it.
And you don't need screens with him, too. He can beat his own guy. There's the flex. They ran it earlier. Ooh.
Yeah.
They got an inside foul, moving screen. I think it may give it to White. I'm not sure.
It does go against Malik White, his second. So he's the second Flyer to come away with 2 fouls. And then
both guards, Timmy.
Right. They're going to get a larger lineup in as Nate Watson checks back in. He dropped, Bill, like 25 or so pounds to get to 250. And you look at him, and he is chiseled. They expect so many great things from this young man. Bishop O'Connell, Arlington, Virginia.
Straight up man, they don't want to leave Washington alone. A shuffle cut ball screen. Pretty good defensive set.
Lynch lost his footing, slip.
Nice pass.
Cartwright to Diallo.
Nice pass. Plenty of time. On the money. This is a seasoned team with a rookie out there for Minnesota, though. They've been in pressure games.
You
can make that, though.
Cartwright skies for the long rebound. Watch out for the motor. He's got 2 gears.
Out of individual play. Got to get the ball off the ground. Good defense.
Yeah.
They got a foul or a walk. Or a timeout.
They got a quick timeout. That was all leather by Bullock. Good hustle play. But how about the city slicker from New York?
Move those puppies around. String music for your old pal Joe Dean, though.
Yeah.
This kid can play. Knock it down.
25-24, our score, Tim Brando, Bill Raftery. The Gavitt tip-off underway, and you're going to be seeing a lot of outstanding college basketball from the Big East and the Big Ten all week long as you look at Richard Pitino. One concern that Providence may have, Bullock got his second foul as we went to break a moment ago. They've got three Friars now, each with two fouls, two guards and Bullock, which could be an issue late in the game.
You know, I'm looking at Richard over there thinking he's been around basketball his whole life.
And,
you know, just calm, relaxed. It's really interesting to watch him work. And today was fun for me. I saw him last year during the Big Ten tournament as well. But what he's been able to do with this program, I mean, they are a legit factor this season. You can see it with their play thus far.
In a lot of ways, Bill, I think always people will talk about his being the son of the Hall of Famer Rick Pitino, but truly, his coaching style is far more Billy Donovan than it is Rick Pitino.
Well, when he was with Tim Welsh, I could tell.
Yeah.
Because he just had a calmness about him. He just grasped different theories and has his own mannerisms as the way he wants to coach.
And he's always asked about his dad, and he'll say, yeah, we talked about family, but when it comes to basketball, I think he shares more with Billy than he does with his
might
father.
Be right.
Diallo.
Are you suggesting that's an age thing?
Here's McBrayer.
He's
the only Gopher that's not scored. They've got the four of the starting five are in the column. McBrayer with his first shot.
But what he did, he had Murphy at the rim, so it did look like a little bit of a quick shot. I just think they got to slow it down a little bit.
Jackson. Well, just in, Isaiah Jackson, the 6'6 junior out of Gainesville, Florida, and Providence has tied it up. Boy, that bench for Providence has been tremendous on this
half.
Lynch saved the day on the loose ball and gets the garbage banker to fall.
Well, they stick with it.
This team, because it's got so many guys that can handle it, you'd figure would be better in the half court this season than they've been in the past. Here's Edwards. The little runner does not fall, and McBrayer comes out of there with it.
Two bookends in there, aren't they? A little giveaway with the wraparounds.
Yeah. Jackson will get the foul. That's his first.
And giving it up at the proper time, so important. Drive, draw, replace. Able to stroke it into the other end. Just great. I thought he may have walked on this one, but just a great penetrator with that size and bulk and ever alert.
Tell you what, when 22 is in a scrum, he's going to win.
Your money's on him, huh?
Boy, Lynch is something special down and along the low block. You hear old coaches use those cliches about grown men. Lynch at 22, 6'10 out of a dynamist, Minnesota. The transfer from Illinois State, he is a grown man. And he's shown it along the low blocks today. Gophers by three. 11 field goals, Bill, for Providence by nine different guys.
A quick weave, and look at this. Oh, should shoot. It's on the pass. Tough, you know.
A little bit of a break there because you're right. Could be in the shot. Reggie Lynch does get the foul.
Yeah, Cartwright really has great vision, though. This is one of those. He knows it's going to be one of the great shot blockers in the country. And that would have been a mistake. And Lynch is saying, what?
he'll get a blow for the first time.
Coming.
Nice screen.
Oh, they went to sleep. Lindsay missed a chippy.
The pump fake cost him. Should have gone right up.
That's a clear out. Offensive foul. Goes against Devontae Fitzgerald.
Providence really can go 9-10 deep, too. Mm-hmm. It's a matter of him finding him, being it really who the rotation is going to be. But once you put that arm out, destiny is not on your side.
P.J. Fleck's team can get away with stiff arms. You can't do that in this game.
Nice screen.
Beautifully done. Inside Watson, everything but the finish. But a foul spotted underneath.
See, the flex really wears you out. You're always getting bumped backside. You got to jam to the ball. You got to slide around it. It's relentless.
Fitzgerald becomes the first Gopher with two fouls. Here's Watson at the line. You know, they got three signees to go along with this veteran team. He's one of them. But you take a look at DeJure Dickens, who we'll see a bit through the course of this night, number 33, and then, of course, the aforementioned Ashton Lankford. And gosh, Bill, the sky is really the limit for how far this team, Providence, could go.
They got some size. You had a little Sir DeJure today. They can get some nice rotation as they get experience, too, particularly when you've got a terrific backcourt rotation. There's that little bag, little screen up.
It's going to be fun to watch Watson deal with Lynch down low if he's in there. And that's a little foul underneath. They'll quickly come in as wanted to make sure they checked on him. Diallo is going to get the foul for the trip.
Now, this is a nickel dimer. This is one of those just play on, I thought.
Yeah.
It hit the floor, it hurts, but I just think that's a misplay.
Yeah. Sometimes the dynamics of the player hitting the floor play a role.
Yeah.
And here's Amir Coffey at the free throw line. And now we're in a double bonus situation, so there's two shots regardless. You know, Coffey's dad played at Minnesota and then also in the NBA with the Timberwolves as well. Yeah.
So are you.
Yes.
Yeah.
I felt that way when Billy the Kid started coaching. And now the kid's in the NBA and he's no kid any longer. You know, the days of Ernie Pops Lewis. Delray Brooks.
A little hand check.
Yep. Well, he was Kipfer. He was a kid during that time. Yeah, David Kipfer, Jacek Duda. It was a part of that starting five.
Some days it wasn't Duda's day. You know that, right?
Oh boy.
This play worked earlier. Better job, Minnesota, with that up screen.
Cartwright, a pull up.
How about that?
How about the elevation?
Yeah, unbelievable athletic. And he's got to be careful though. You don't want to show up the ref.
6 points, five assists already for Kyron.
A little double screen after the. Look at this pull up.
That's going to be an over the back on Konate.
That is, he gets after him though. That he's got two over the top. But when you have a guard that can knock down some shots and make plays, and Cooley will smile. This is one of those deals. Don't bark now, bark later. You want them on your side. The Southpaw strikes again for the Friars.
Ranked teams out of both of these power conferences, and maybe just on the outside is Providence, along with Butler. Those are the two getting votes outside the top 25. And the Iowa Hawkeyes, Fran McCaffrey's got a good club that might also be ranked very soon.
No question about it. Iowa is one of those teams that someone has forgotten. And Providence, when you think of it, in this situation. But this level of play this early is just really amazing.
Well, these kids now spend so much time, Bill, in the summer honing their games and getting better. You know, I look at Watson as a result. He probably was at 265 or 270. The young man that Ed Cooley was able to get in here, and he is now able to run the floor at 250. I mean, he's got an Alonzo Mourning look about him going up and down the floor. A young Alonzo, but Alonzo.
Some teams are honed better when they have better talent, by the way.
Well honed.
There's the little flex cut that we talk about on Providence. Same kind of a set. It controls the tempo, really aggravates the bigs because they must communicate. Nice duck in here.
Well, this is a great matchup, Bill. Well done by Watson defensively. He won that battle.
I tell you, the refs are really letting them play, though. I mean, you know, it's been fair on both sides, competitive, and nothing out of the ordinary.
Providence with an opportunity to take the lead.
Screen and slip, pretty good D. Down to nine.
Off the back rim.
Well, you don't get by those checkouts. Lynch and Murphy.
End-to-end Mason. He went right into the chest of Jalen Lindsay, and Lindsay will pick up the foul.
Great going either way, though, isn't he? Has a great feel for the pulse of the game. Good, strong leadership.
That'll put Mason to the free throw line.
The first team Big Ten. I guess you should be mature, huh?
Yeah. This kid. Decatur, Georgia. Arlington Country Day. Well, Sunday, a great slate of games featured the Redskins and the Saints. Boy, they ran 18 straight rushing plays against Buffalo and just annihilated them in Buffalo. And Drew Brees out to a great year. Seven straight wins for the Saints after starting the year 0-2. It all begins right here on Fox.
You never know,
regional games.
Never know you were from Louisiana the way you read that with such feeling.
Well, all my original thoughts are written.
I'll tell you, defense on both sides.
Watson.
He didn't think he fouled again.
Yeah, Lynch picked it up.
Watson really is good in that low box area. Plays with a lot of confidence. Watch this drop step here with some strength. Should go to the left hand there and hold this guy off. May have gotten the basket and one.
So Watson at the free throw line with an opportunity to give PC. Well, he doesn't have the chance now, but they led the game 2-0, got their opening sequence, got a layup, and then were outscored 12-0. A quick timeout was taken at the 16:05 mark, and since then, Providence has been very competitive.
Should have stiff arms that shot, doesn't he?
A little low trajectory.
Yeah, and then he just pulls it. Get a little bit of a blow.
Elite Young checks back in for Watson. Now, this has been, as advertised, an outstanding matchup of a top 15 team against probably an undervalued Friars team that should be ranked.
And Diallo now has the assignment on Washington. Empty side.
Only one field goal in the last 5:50 for Minnesota.
Nice show here.
Fitzgerald in traffic, stays with it. Loose ball to Cartwright.
Got a trail man.
Yep. On the wing, Jackson for three.
Interesting. They played Diallo and left the baseline jumper open. That's what happens when you have numbers on the fast break.
First lead since Two Love. 8-1 run for PC, and that's a lot.
Washington may be trying to do a little bit too much to ignite that offense.
Well, this is exactly the kind of atmosphere Richard wanted for this team to have early on in the season. They're getting the full brunt of Providence's home court advantage. Lindsay, a rainbow! Icicles coming down. Magnificent run here by Ed Cooley's team. And what we've noticed, Bill, is, you know, they got three guys with two fouls, but no big deal. Just get some other guys out. The reinforcements have been the difference in this game for Coach Cooley.
They sure have. Inside defense, too, has been extraordinary. Able to negate the bigs at the rim, finish it off with a defensive rebound. And the open floor, if you don't retreat and identify, and this team has a lot of guys. Oh, there was Mike Trangisi at Cooley's disposal.
Yeah, well, speaking of
a connection,
the old Big East commissioner, right-hand man to Dave Gavitt in those formative years.
One of the most respected men in athletics, too.
You know, he's been consulting the SEC in basketball, and look at the resurgence that league has had.
No question.
Since he got involved.
See how they handle this ball script. They trap it. They switch it. The hands crossed it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Foul was prior to the shot.
There's
taking it all in.
He should get a monitor, though. He can't see half the game in that seat. What a guy. He was with Dave early on, and just so helpful to everybody, administrators, coaches,
no
players.
Yeah. And I think he's as proud of the rebirth of the new Big East as anyone. And, you know, when you think about it, Bill, in so many ways, those teams that did leave that had football priorities, they found a wonderful home, and our old friend Mike Resco runs that league.
Sure.
So it all, in the end, it all worked out for everyone. But Val has got to be just absolutely ecstatic. I saw Steve Jackson earlier, too. For the league to do what it did at this early stage of its reformation, amazing.
Absolutely. Great administration.
Nate Mason has 10 in the game for Minnesota.
They got an offensive foul, yep. I think, underneath Isaiah, was it?
It does go against Khalif Young. That's Young, number three, yeah, on him. So Ed will have to go quickly back to his bench and get DeJure Dickens into the game for the first time. This is the freshman 7-footer from Bethel High in Hampton, Virginia.
He can run the floor.
Yep.
You know, does a really nice looking stroke, blocks some shots.
Yeah, this is a same school that Bullock came from. Ivan Thomas, his assistant, had him, and they were able to recruit this kid as a result of Bullock's success.
Yeah, there's a little matchup. He should be able to offensive rebound unless he not.
Oh, a teardrop on the baseline. That's a beauty.
Looking for help.
Oh.
And Jackson just let him go.
You can watch that kid play all night long.
Look at this play. Gotta catch it.
My goodness.
That's hard of growing. Well, he can drag people. Kenny Cartwright,
yeah,
great vision. Now you're thinking rebound. If you're Providence, make sure you screen off. And of course, get a good look late with a chance to tip it in.
Only tenths of a
Gophers.
Second. Only tenths of a second, the differential. Basically holding for one. Great ball movement to Coffey. Bonatti at the buzzer.
They're going to check it.
They're going to check it, but it's going to count.
That's why you think defensive rebounding in that situation.
That one will count. We are in the dunk, and Coffey is sold. But he left that one, and Isaiah, the freshman sensation from Harlem, just went straight up.
He plays with a lot of confidence, that kid. Very alert. The feel for the game, and I think it may be good. What do you think?
I think they're waving it off.
Wow,
that is a break. It was counted originally,
yeah,
but they waved it off. So don't count the basket. In that case, the iron wasn't unkind. The seconds were.
Oh, I thought we were going to get away with a half.
Yeah. Well, that's the end of the half. 39-36. Providence with the lead. We'll send you to Greg Wolf and Jimmy Jackson for the Jeep Grand Cherokee halftime report. And we will do it right after this. College Hoops on FS1 is sponsored by Jeep Grand Cherokee. It's been a hoop junkie's delight, the Gavin tip-off here in Providence, Rhode Island, a three-point lead for the Friars, who only got their second lead very late in the first half. Tim Brando along with Bill Raftery. I just love the fluidity of this game.
Right, nice to see you excited.
Yeah.
And why not? I mean, they're leaving it all out there, no question about it. Will Minnesota get a little more in sync, though?
Yeah.
Guards occasionally have gone on their own and forgotten the big guys. That's part of this process. And counter that, you know, the backcourt of Providence, particularly Cartwright, finding people.
Well, you're looking at our first half stat sponsored by Jeep Grand Cherokee. To your point, the youngster from Harlem, Isaiah Washington, he's a fantastic talent. But, yeah, we didn't hear as much from Lynch. or Jordan Murphy once he got into the game.
But that's going to come about, though, his feel. He's starting the second half because he did play well. Took a lot of solid kind of shots. A lot of make looks, though. Coffey's had a couple of opportunities. Here's a late little trap. They worked on this today. Yeah. This is a break. Oh, I thought that may have been a foul.
Or at least a deflection off of Coffey with 13 on the shot clock. Minnesota will keep possession of it here.
Both of us saw this today. Let him bounce it a couple of times. Come a little late when his vision is somewhat impaired.
Here's Amir backing in.
Loves to come back to that right shoulder. Now he's a foul.
Yeah.
He's been struggling a little bit. Better player than that. 0-for-5 at this point.
Great defensive work by Isaiah Jackson in this sequence.
Well, look how far he moves him from the block. That catch is supposed to be right at the outside of the lane, and here favoring that right shoulder, lean in, made it a tough delivery.
By the way, Cartwright's been outstanding, Bill. Over half the Friars' points have come off Sunday best dishes, and he has no turns.
No steps, yeah.
Until now.
Yeah. Good call.
Yeah.
His father will be calling you. But he rolled into that. You know, a lot of kids practice that. And when it comes game time, continue it.
Gave him the old announcer jinx there, praising him for no turnovers, and bada bing, bada boom, he picks up his first.
Well, they get Lynch to the box now. A good recovery. Here comes that trap. Yeah, he hit that.
Low. Murphy and Lynch.
Well,
get it to him.
That's the experience they had. They don't get back, though. This is inexperience.
Oh, yeah, and Lynch picks up the foul as a result.
That's not his fault.
Yep.
Other people have to play him for him if he's late coming back.
And he's letting them know about it,
yeah,
too.
He's the last one down.
And that's the third on Reggie Lynch, so he gave himself up there.
See, there's the double. They didn't handle it well the last time, but they were ready because they were experienced. And right now, he's the last guy down, and somebody's got to play him until he returns.
Yeah, and Khalif Young just snuck out, a little snowbird maneuver on his part, and he got to the free throw line as a result. If there's an under the radar Flyer, Bill, it might be this guy right here. During the summer, he really worked on his body, got himself in great shape, and now running the floor a lot better for Ed Cooley, this young man.
Okay, he's okay, young. Okay.
Yeah.
What's the process up front for him? You know, without Holt being out there, a lot of new faces are going to get a lot of minutes.
Yeah, and Holt is a player. Emmett Holt is a player that Ed Cooley fought at the end of last year, was his tough guy, was a difference maker to make that NCAA tournament run.
Got to keep Konate off the glass, though. That's his shot. Rebound to miss.
Oh, he left it for him. Murphy grazes the iron.
Oh, nice job checking out that time by Young.
Cartwright.
Too easy, really.
Ooh, the iron really unkind there.
Boy, you can't leave him alone like that.
Washington.
Where you going?
Lost it.
2-on-1. Give it up.
Oh, boy, he didn't. That was a mistake.
Should have been back and forth to one another. A trip.
Yeah.
Cartwright.
Not one of his finer moments right there.
No. Too good a player.
He knows it. That's his first personal foul, and he says, yeah, my bad. He's tapping his chest right there. You could see it.
We should have an announcer's my bad. You know? Our numbers, our numbers have, could be high, though.
They'd have mine on an endless loop. Murphy and Lynch have been the linchpins, really, of this Minnesota half-court offense. When 3 and 22 have had touches, they've been successful.
Rush screen.
There's 3. Murphy off the back iron this time.
Rebound.
Jackson.
Wow. Another run out.
Look, Young again. He's running the floor like a deer.
And nobody's seeing the ball. No vision. And the backcourt not doing a good job bailing the bigs out.
Well, you love to see bigs get up and down the floor like that. There's a foul against Diallo.
The rebound and push, and then you see all the heads, the back. And we don't have a telestrator. We're trying to point here. You've got to cover and then peel back off.
You guys should have seen that. It was like Raftery was the weatherman without a pointer. Mason, beautiful dish. Murphy again.
You get two blocking a shot. Another run out.
Look at that.
And off his leg.
Yeah, it's a deflection.
It should be the other way.
Yeah, it should be.
Ooh, that's a break.
Yeah, it is, because nice Washington definitely slapped it away. And it went off of Young here.
Watch this, right off his leg.
Yep.
Yeah,
that's a big break for Providence. Remember in the last couple of minutes in the game, they can go to the replay for that.
Check it out.
Yep.
Nice footwork.
Oh!
How about that spin? Under control. Against some inside basket, so important. The lefty here, everything but a little juice on that delivery.
Bakari Konate picks up that foul. That's his third. And that's kind of my point about Young, Bill. You look at him, and unlike Watson and maybe Bullock, you don't think that necessarily he's got that much offensive game. But he does.
He also can run the floor. Yeah. We've seen that.
Indeed.
He gets out. Big, strong kid.
Inside touches for Minnesota. They're 1 of 11 from downtown as a team. So the issue from beyond the arc is ever present.
Smart, Mason. I think he knew on the bounce he could do some damage. Isaiah Jackson at a disadvantage.
And Isaiah picks up his second.
Anytime you use those hands, you can just see them in there. Containment. I'm going to straighten it out here. Guys getting a little mixed up.
You think it's pretty clear that Richard Pitino talked to his guys about straight line drives to the basket?
A little bit, I'm sure. I just think they got to get some touches. Of course, they don't have that powerful lineup in there up front. Just one, Murph.
Washington and Mason in the backcourt. A little run out from Bullock on a show. Washington for three.
A push.
Well, Konate.
That's three of them on the offensive glass.
Yeah, and he's got four
all three
for the game. And Richard's going to have to get him out of there.
It is embarrassing being in this town with you. You know, we go to all these Italian restaurants. You never introduce anybody. You got your boys. You get your lemonade and anything else you want.
Too many cannolis, I'll tell you that. Come to Providence and you're going to get your fair share.
I didn't find any corned beef in town. I know that.
We should thank you, by the way, since Steve Shear is not here, and we wish him all of the best. He fell ill. Our lead producer, PT Navarro, makes his home here as in
play.
Young puts it in.
The inside screen again, that little flex cut. And you're right about Steve. Had a little stomach issue on the road. Now he's doing fine, thank God. But this is just good, solid basketball. The flex gets you, the cross screen. And all of a sudden, number 11 clears it. And then the power at the block. Young, step it up.
Steve will be happy to know you picked up the check last night at Canteen's, one of our favorite Italian bistros. Legendary place here in Providence, Rhode Island. Boy, Young, all of the points for Providence have come from number 13 in gray. Cleve Young.
He knows they got him outside where he can dribble drive. A tough matchup for the bigs. That time a disadvantage for Young. Jackson had him for a second. This kid, explosive with some strength. You just can't move the puppies quick enough, and he'll challenge them all.
I think he was a little tired of Cleve Young making all that noise on the other end.
I think they may have gotten Diallo with that foul, but that is an aggressive move by a guy stepping up with his partner Lynch out. This team is road worthy in that conference. The venues they have to play in.
You can imagine, as physical as they are, then you go into that pit that is the Williams Arena.
Great spot.
Very unique place for
look
basketball.
Look at this. Same play.
Backdoor cut rejected.
What a save.
Murphy. The little guy stays with it, though, as does Young. And he's fouled.
What a save by Murphy, though. Boy, sticking with it, both ends of the floor, showing an amazing ticker, a resiliency, and protecting without his partner in there as well. Great leadership qualities.
46-43. Bill, you said earlier the kind of shape you need to be in to play so fast and so strong. Look at this.
Look at the action. Jordan Murphy saves the goal, doesn't give up on the play. Look, right back in. He's got partners to assist him. Incredible effort. And that's what you got to do to win basketball games anymore. The reaction, the speed, the snap judgments, the hustle, the all-out effort. And that's just one trip.
Yeah. You look at college basketball from a global point of view, and it's easy to take shots. But for those of us that love it, that sequence right there, that's why we love it.
Leaving it all out, so important.
This kid has been a difference maker in the second half for Providence. He's got all 8 points in this half.
Now they're going with Jordan Murphy at the other end with some consistency, whatever the matchup. Now they're going real small. Now, let's check that.
Great response to Young coming out.
And Lindsey coming in too, yeah. Maybe, you know.
Tim Brando, Bill Raftery, happy to have you with us. The Gavitt tip-off here on FS1. The first of so many this week. You're going to love it. College basketball is back.
He's a gamer, this kid. He knows what to take, when to take. There's a throw on the floor. They have a little baseline bump, too.
Nate Mason, senior leader for this Minnesota team.
It's that elbow entry they used to run at BC with Al Skinner. And Ed was the assistant there.
This youngster was on the bench for a while because of some early foul difficulty. But you can see what a difference he makes when he's on the floor, Makai Ashton Langford.
And he's got that good left-hand bounce, yeah, too, so he can exploit either way. The dummy play.
Oh, boy. They fell asleep. Bullet. Watson stays with it and puts it in.
A tippy-toe delivery.
Ah.
Because he had bodied his man under the rim.
Providence has got some bounce in the building, and they lead by four.
I like the Murph matchup, to be honest with you. I don't like that.
Yeah.
That's not his game either.
Loose ball.
We're going to run. Easy.
Good job by Cartwright to get Lindsey out of there. Nothing needed to happen there, and the senior did a nice job. Fitzgerald gets the foul, his fourth.
This is the problem here. They weren't ready on the inbound. You see Mason was telling them where to go. He didn't angle properly. And all of a sudden, you don't see the entry pass. But this is exposing the bounce and creating havoc here. That's great hard basketball. No problem whatsoever.
I love the move by Cartwright to get Lindsey up and get him out of there. That's leadership.
That's what your point guard's for.
Yep. By the way, you see the young man coming in, Michael Hurt. He's number 42 for Minnesota.
You do the same thing for me, by the way. Get me out of places late at night. Make sure I get home.
With a phone call shortly afterwards, right?
Exactly.
Bench points now for PC, leading 17-8 over Minnesota. Really the difference in the game.
Murphy really plays within the framework of the team. Nice curl.
Yeah. Not there. A little bit out of control. There's Hurt with the rebound. So many deflections out there.
Hurt can stick that outside shot.
Coffee!
Got it! That's his, going to his left hand. Able to finish. They need some play out of him, I think.
That's his first field goal,
yeah,
Bill.
He struggled.
And Amir Coffee, as you mentioned, is a bright and shining star for Minnesota. So look out, he may light up now.
Shuffle cut and pin down. It's amazing how the teams react to the scouting report. Oh, for offense.
Yeah. That's an offensive foul.
No question. You got to jump that left hand. Know your scouting report as they reverse the basketball. Right here, you can see cheat step, the foot speed, the inability of Watson to move the puppies and counter.
That's beautiful pass. And he got it to number three, and good things happen when Murphy gets the touch.
They switched to a matchup and didn't communicate. Nice slip by Murph.
You can see where Hurt does play with a high basketball IQ. The sophomore, great number look. 42.
They got an offensive foul.
Yeah.
I think they're signaling number five, if I'm not mistaken, and it would be Bullock.
Yep. Excellent. For Rodney, that is his third, and that's important because he's the guy that in the late stretch run, Ed Cooley wants to play with abandon.
With the ebb and flow here, having control of the game to losing it right now, Minnesota, much more effective.
McBrayer,
we got it the other way.
Yeah.
Good jump. What a move.
Smart
move. Gets himself in position.
And Mekhi Ashton-Langford is playing with foul difficulty, and he just got Dupree McBrayer's second. Attrition could be an issue for both of these teams late, particularly Providence, but they have been the deeper team.
Can you play it all 25?
No. Boy, there's the in-between game. Not many young guys have that.
Well, that flex tires you out. You're across, up and down.
That's going to be a block.
He is strong, too, isn't he? Nice discard by Mason. But you're moving up and down. You're getting screened. Your man screens. Rescreened. Here's the slip. And all of a sudden, you're on the wrong side. Murph's caught in Neverland. Should I go help or resist?
There aren't many young guys that play the in-between game that well. That's a lost art. And you saw there from Ashton Langford why he was so highly celebrated coming out of high school. And Cartwright's going to get a quick blow. And Malik White, the sophomore from Richmond, checks in for him.
And Timmy, that's a good move because you've got 45 seconds to the next TV timeout. Hit Cartwright a little bit of blow, and you're coming in with an effective performer as well.
Well, we've been in this building many times before and seen Ed Cooley's team come from double digits behind and win games. And a few years ago, it might have been Chris Dunn. Right now, it's with Tyron Cartwright. Mm-hmm.
Or Cotton a few years before that.
Yep.
He's had some good players.
In a town that has seen some of the great guards of all time in college basketball, dating all the way back to Ernie D.
He was a great one. They got a hold on the box, I think, by Hurt. Yeah. That's that motion, though. That's a little cross diagonal screen. You trail. Trying to regain position.
One and one time after the first foul on Hurt. By the way, Michael Hurt's younger brother is a junior now in high school, and they are going,
say super,
oh,
huh?
He's an unbelievable talent. Might even be a one and done.
It's amazing how young and talented kids are.
And the question comes up all the time, I'm sure, with Michael playing and his brother being where he is, you know, what do you think, coach? And I loved what Richard said to us today. He's told the parents, I want Michael to make every shot he makes. Every shot he takes, yep.
Analysis, huh?
55-52.
Don't forget, all of this is hanging right there with that Lynch. Murph used the dribble. There you go.
Ooh, is that a strong move?
I don't know how he got it.
How strong is that?
He was full. Look at him run back. Because he knows what a hustler this kid is. What does he leave it out there?
15 in the game for Jordan Murphy, and he sort of picked up where he left off Friday night. He had 35 in a career high against USC Upstate. Watson right back at him. Murphy comes down with a rebound.
Yeah, he gives it all.
Bill, he's a scoring machine, Murphy.
He's a player. I mean, that's what he is. Look, he ducked in. They had him.
If you don't double him, he'll make you pay.
Tony's got a cut.
Shot clock down to six. Mason's got to do it on his own.
Look at this hustle and a foul. Just out scrapped. Wow, well, Chris, you know you've missed it, so you really track it down. Jackson with the foul.
That is number three on Isaiah. Right now, Minnesota looks like they really want it more. 55-54, and let's take you inside the huddle. Moments ago, Ed Cooley talking to his team.
Listen, hey, let's be relentless defensively. We're good. We're in a good spot. We got to get every second shot. For us, no loose balls for them. Dive on the floor. Whose ball is it? Jump ball. Our ball.
They shoot a free throw. Oh, yes, yes, yes.
That's our ball on a jump ball, so we don't need to call timeout. Okay? Let's keep playing with pace. See if we can get out in transition. All right? Get out in transition.
We should be
fresh coming in here. Right? Got a rebound. All right? Let's try hammering transition. All right? Hey, it's a long time. Keep playing with some passion, some joy, and some energy. Get the build into the game right now. All right? Let's go.
So positive, isn't it? Makes you feel good. Chris, pushing the ball so important. The bigs have to run the floor as they did earlier. And you notice the assistant saying Murphy's name, but he couldn't get in. It's like, you got to guard that guy.
Well, by the way, he just saw a loose ball situation go Minnesota's way. And he said, get the loose balls. Right. And you see Mason at the free throw line. Fast break points have been with his team, Providence, 8-2 in this game. They've led the entire half, but by no more than six. So Minnesota with an opportunity to take its first lead of the second half off of this free throw by Nate Mason.
He's gotten four in a row. If he makes this one, he's forced the issue with his hustle. Gets a little bit of a blow now.
I'll be interested to see, Bill, if Murphy continues to be as strong a presence now that the freshman has come in, Isaiah Washington. Because when Mason's out there, he gets the rock.
Little scissor play. They've not run that all game.
Oh, beautiful.
Look at that rebound, the elevation.
Murphy
pursuit.
Something.
That's effort.
And he clears people out when he makes rebounds. Right to the hoop. Nothing doing. Taken down by Watson. There's a steal by Isaiah. Washing with a steal. Head to the pilfer. Count it. And a foul. The little guy from Harlem came in and played strong there.
They forced the issue. Don't give up on a play. You got to protect the basketball. That would be six in a row if they make these two on that free throw line.
And that gives McBrayer a chance for a three-point play.
And this guy can't relax. Protect the ball. This, I actually thought they could have passed the ball if they had coffee on the other side as well.
Yeah, I think Isaiah wanted it back, didn't he? But McBrayer did get the hoop, and now miss at an old-fashioned three-point play. 58-55, 12-4 run now for Minnesota.
Cartwright back on the floor now.
He's got 9 assists tonight, Bill. He had 10 against Houston Baptist the other night.
This is where they need him, though. He struggled the last few times, not finishing deals. Well, he's got a mid that can really mystify an opponent.
By the way, if the building is going to get going again, as Ed Cooley wanted, Cartwright is the guy that can make that happen.
Yeah, Lynch, such a factor, screening and slipping, loading up in the lane. Here's Murphy, an opportunity to rest. He's been all out. Coffee, big. He missed a couple early. Spot on for him.
Got great touch, soft left-handed touch.
Horns look. And a yo-yo.
The freshman got it on the iron and does collect the foul.
Well, they do a nice job with their quick hitters, but you got to challenge and get up on a guy. Good job keeping yourself busy. This little penetration opens it up. A late close, you pay.
Makai Ashton Langford at the free throw line. Tantalizingly kind there, wasn't it? He touched all of the rim. Touch them all. Well, you just have to love the versatility that Providence has at their beck and call. That they can use so many different guys, Bill, and Minnesota is playing at a very high level tonight.
Well, the big thing that Ed was saying to both of us today was who to have playing with whom.
Yeah.
And that's what they're searching for. They are deeper, but it's just the correct group to be out there. You don't risk Murph too long.
Yeah. I think he loves the idea, too, that he can get Cartwright off the ball some this year.
Yeah.
Hurd goes reversal. Strong move by Michael Hurd.
Nice little call, too. Use that rim.
Well, he was the runner-up for Minnesota Basketball Player of the Year when he was in high school, so no slouch coming out himself. Here's Bullock chasing up.
Wow. With him right there, too. Quick timeout for Ed Cooley. He felt it slipping just a little bit. Bullock with the confidence to knock it down.
Well, the lead is up to 5. They've made 9 of their last 13. You never want to get hurt quite like this, Bill.
It's painful. Nice job. A little late close. Finishing it big time.
Well, he created a basketball conference that made basketball, college basketball, so popular. And, you know, those old Big East games, I mean, I still watch them when they're on TV. And then from a Providence College standpoint, being an alum, he meant so much to that university, to that city, and obviously a lot to my family. So his vision made college basketball popular. And he's a special, special man because of that.
Think of the coaches as we take you. Julie doesn't miss a game.
No.
She's unbelievable.
No,
she put me on the phone with Corey, who's an independent entrepreneur, very successful. Of course, Danny, president of basketball for the NCAA, and she just loves her basketball and her Friars. So she's a hearty fan.
Yeah.
But Richard's comments, the institutions had so many great coaches. When you go back to Mulaney,
right.
There's Rick Barnes, you know, one after another, they've been successful. Of course, they bring them to the Final Four in St. Louis. What a thrill. You mentioned DiGregorio and Barnes and Stakem. Pretty good group of players.
The love of not only the game currently, but also the history of it is right here in this town.
He can drive. Look at him first.
He's just so strong.
Power. Personified.
If you don't double him, he's going to light you up for double-doubles all season long. And I guarantee you the rest of the Big Ten is aware of that after watching tonight's game.
That was a bad defense on him either.
He's got 17.
Nice block. Here he is.
Bullock with a rejection. He gets it back. Mr. Chippy Diallo.
They got Diallo with a foul.
I think they got Diallo with a foul. That's right. It's going the other way. Here's Murphy
this?
Today.
What do you think? He just loads up, competes. Leaves it all out there. Steps up, unselfish play as well. Cuts, reads, understands the game.
Fans just now finding out that Diallo did get that foul on a push.
And even the reaction to that play,
yeah.
Looks like a layup. Minnesota is in outstanding shape to pursue.
And the difference, Bill, is dominating the paint. And it's Murphy. And now Lynch is back in the game now. But they've done the job down low, 18-6. They've scored or outscored Providence points in the paint. And that's in just this half.
Mm-hmm.
This kid, Dupree McGrayer, out of Queens, New York, Sunrise Christian Academy.
They were saying he had a foot injury all summer,
yeah.
Too, which slowed down his progression.
Yep. He had a fantastic close to last season for Coach Pitino. 66-60. 8.5 remaining.
Automatic switch on the perimeter.
This kid's been lights out in the
tough
second
shot.
Half.
Tough shot. Look at him guy. He went from the foul line diagonally to pursue that. Jordan, amazing.
Minnesota,
not a good one here. He's got to figure out he doesn't have to do it in a hurry.
Well, they've scored on their last 8 trips down the floor. Why not be patient?
Yeah, that's part of learning, though. You get away with some things in high school.
He likes that spot. He likes it.
Yep. And that's that replace, too. All the attention on the ball and the screen.
Largest lead of the night. It's up to 9.
This is an urgent trip right here. Got to get a good one or get to the foul line. They got the mismatch. Tough shot.
Full of Ponderosa. A little bonanza from Cartwright.
Goodness.
Did they need that?
This is where they got to play a little better. Fatigue factor right now. Cross screen, they got him if they want, Murph. They got the bookends together here. Oh, not a good look.
Lindsey saved it to the wrong guy. And he's got caffeined up.
Wow. He was silent, no longer. What a counter.
I'll have another cup of that coffee. Wow. 72-63. Here's your guy, Mano a Mano.
Hands.
That's a push. It's Cartwright time, Bill, for Providence.
They have really stepped up big time. They need him. This was a trip that was necessary to ring the bell at the other end. Oh, there's the splendor. Goodness, he has been splendid.
Well, make the extra pass.
The access that we get inside the huddle now of Richard Pitino as his Golden Gophers have catapulted to a 9-point lead.
Hey, you're battling, man. You're battling. Hey, we know that when we play together, we can beat anybody. Run a one. Guys, move the ball. You make the extra pass, you're getting open looks.
Pretty good information, though. He's got the attention. They understand what he wants. They are playing organized basketball, solid, competitive, very basic. Yeah, running their stuff on the offensive end to get the good looks and coming up with the loose ball.
I loved what he said too. You know, you can play with anybody.
Mm-hmm.
You play together, you can play with anybody.
That's
He's got at only 35, Bill. He's such an old soul.
He is.
Because he's been around this great game for so long. I loved what he said to you today about his memories here. He says, you know, people ask me where I'm from and I'm really not sure. He said, I think I feel more at home when I'm here because I went to school here and I worked here as an early assistant coach. But I think where he belongs is on a basketball floor. That's where he belongs.
See, when I talk to him, I feel like I'm the teenager. I mean, he is so grounded. Well, and there he is. How about that, taking a visit?
I remember him.
I wonder if he dropped off a check. Take care of the Friars. Come on, Richard.
I remember him as a little kid at his dad's practices.
Mm-hmm. His brother Ryan here. I saw him earlier. Great group of kids.
Shot clock under 10. Mason.
Little zone look through the wrinkle.
That's where you want it. That's where you want it.
The cut. He set it up himself. He popped into the lane and they don't get back, but tough luck. Tough luck at that time, anyhow.
Yeah. Lynch did get the deflection.
Lynch got himself. It's just this move into the lane. The zone sort of mystified it for a moment, but look at this bailout. Ball fake. Sets the man up right. Goes left. Finishes the deal.
This has been an offensive clinic, Bill, in this half. They're 64% from the floor, 4 of 6 from downtown, and a 20-6 advantage right now in the paint.
Mm. Well, they got a playmaker in Murphy up front. Besides, you got Mason running the show.
And the Providence bigs, while they're really good, they're really young.
Here's the playmaker taking over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No answer.
No.
Bullock was on his own and there was no answer.
Now, if you go to help, you know he's going to surprise with a drop off.
21 on the night now for Jordan Murphy. Friars are going to make a run. They need to become efficient on this end. This guy's got to make it happen. Along with Bullock. Good pass.
Pretty.
Very good pass.
Nice little setup with the pump fake. This is where you got to tee it up.
Cartwright with 9 assists, Bill, but only 2 in the second half.
Yeah, he's looking to score a little bit more. High low, a nice job defensively.
Here they come. Try to get this building involved, and they will. Minnesota had scored on their last 12 trips prior to that miss.
Double high, not a bad pass.
McBrayer.
Oh, that was a read set up easily. Cartwright a little bit sloppy.
Yeah,
not realizing this team reads and knows the scouting report. That was a double high ball screen.
There's Lindsey. Bullock trying to keep it alive, and I think will have it over the back. This one may go against Murphy.
Now, when you're making a comeback, you can't make mistakes. Now, he drags people, but the weak side defender, who's extremely alert in this particular play, rise in and finish it big time. And the kid's going to be pretty good, I think, huh?
Man, oh, man, he is a solid, solid talent. And, you know, Coach Pitino was telling us at his shoot-around today, he wasn't sure how his guys would respond to the large stage, because maybe they're not sure about Providence. Mm-hmm. He was, but yeah. He wasn't sure about his guy. I think they certainly got the memo.
Mm-hmm. I think Providence got the retention, too, but he's hanging tough there.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Obviously, plenty of time left here, but it's the other end that they're having some difficulties. Nice little tip there by Lynch. They're an intelligent team and talented.
Not quite as deep yet as maybe some other teams in the Big Ten, but boy, they're solid. And I don't see any sign of them being wimpy.
Well, they back off because he's dribbled by them, created for others, and now that lethal weapon with that jumper.
The lead is a baker's dozen, 80 to 67.
Gotta run some stuff. Dribbling's not gonna help.
Nice dump down here to Bullock. Jump stop and the deuce.
Pretty. A quick timeout again, get a sub in. Get the Diallo on the floor.
You think there's another run?
I would be surprised in this building.
You and I recall, Bill, when Chris Mack's team caught fire last year, they were depleted, had all kinds of injuries. Trayvon stepped it up in the Big East tournament and then went all the way to the Elite Eight. And I think we've seen tonight in Murphy a guy that does much the same for Minnesota.
Speaking of good players, the ability to lean on people, initiate contact with his body search, footwork with the drop step, and also, let me show you a little bit of a 17-footer. Knockdown. Big time performance.
They got to find a way to either deny him the ball or maybe double. What do you do? I mean, he's just been a difference maker.
If you do even rake a little bit or lean over to his side, he has that ability to find the cutter.
Yeah.
I mean, I think you got to play him straight up. First time pressure all game. They got a little nickel dimer here.
On White.
Yep.
And at this stage, I'm sure Ed Cooley's okay with sending him and using some of those fouls and extend the game to some extent as Cartwright looks to check back in.
Well, it's interesting. You run that particular press, you've got to take away the sideline.
Yeah.
And Waite was a little tardy getting his foot over there.
Well, the Gavitt games continue tomorrow. The 20th ranked Purdue Boilermakers take on Marquette. Wojo against Matt Painter, 8:30 Eastern. Then on Wednesday, Butler squares off with Maryland. It's all this week on FS1 or stream it live on Fox Sports Go.
Yeah, Matt's got himself a team again. They're going to be good.
I know you and Gus will be together on Wednesday. I'll catch up with you in Madison, Wisconsin on Thursday with that Xavier team you'll be seeing next. Give you a little preview of what will be a great matchup at the Kohl Center. Lindsay off the front iron, run down by Mason.
See, the company likes to give you a couple of days off to rest your vocal cords.
I'm not as young as I used to be.
Put them to good use.
Minnesota now shooting 68%, Bill, in this half, and in large measure because of number three.
Yeah, they don't have to be in a hurry. I don't think they needed that one.
No, they helped out Providence there.
Plenty of time on the clock.
Bullock again. Air ball, and that was a quick shot.
Yeah, they need it more than the Gophers.
Right away, Ed Cooley gets his youngsters up, two of his fine freshmen, and that's a reach-in foul against Bullock on Lynch.
Right, we both thought the same thing, though, to me. You know, you watch the UConn game, they really look good. Then they had a flat tire in another game, an exhibition game. And that's what it's going to be like. That's why I thought this was a great learning experience for this team. Well, if you got the win, that's one thing. Obviously, that's what you're here for. But I think they can get a great deal out of this game against a wonderful Minnesota team.
Absolutely.
Well-coached team as well.
And they're going to be playing some big games in the next week or two, Providence.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're in New York, and they get back here for BC on our air in a couple of weeks.
I'm very impressed by Nate Watson, who just checked back into the game. And Makai Ashton Langford, what he can do, the kid from Worcester, that can allow Cartwright to play off the ball, and that's what we're going to see right now.
There's a lot of nice pieces here. Eddie knows that. A little late by Lynch, but
steps. Yeah, Watson with steps, well defended by Lynch.
Well, you know he's a shot blocker. You got that in the back of your head. Looming large.
This was like a matchup, a heavyweight matchup, where experience in the end and brawn and strength was the difference for Minnesota.
What I like about both teams, and Minnesota handling success right now, just playing basketball, both of them. No silliness, no wolfing.
Yeah. And this is going to be, in the end, a game that's lasting margin will not indicate how closely played it was, as the shot clock winds down on McBrayer.
Well, too late.
Yeah.
That's all right. You get one of the two things you want.
Yeah.
You know? You like the score, but you use the whole time.
Tough night for Cartwright in the second half.
It just gave him a little slap, too. Yeah. You know, a little. He knows more than anybody.
You're not going to find a more positive guy than Cooley.
Well, he's got an opportunity to really have fun coaching his group.
I love chatting with him today, Bill. He's already looking around the league. He says, I'm watching every game. I'm checking out how I'm going to do, how we're going to match up with this team. You know, that DePaul team looked really good Saturday night, you know?
Yeah.
He just loves the game. Jordan Murphy picking up his fourth foul. Having a scuffle at one end of the floor, we're not going to take time to show any of that to you. More concerned about what's going on the floor rather than off it.
Don't ruin a good night.
Yep.
The referee's waiting to get an to start play.
Richard's like, let's play.
Oh, get it going.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't let people.
I love that. Richard just says, hey, let's move this thing along. The longer we don't play, the longer more people are going to start watching what's going on elsewhere. We don't need to. I can't wait to see how this Minnesota team matches up against some of the other high-end teams in the Big Ten this year. Of course, we welcome that schedule to our distribution on the Fox family of networks all season long.
Some great venues, terrific teams, great programs.
A lot of history. Mason.
He loves that little move. Look at him come back now and save it. They've done that a couple of times. One at a crucial time, if you remember, Isaiah Washington got a steal.
Well, when Isaiah and Mason start learning how to play off of one another, they're going to be really tough to beat. They already are in many respects.
And you got a couple of wings.
McBrayer. Hey. Everything but the finish. Lindsay gets it out under a minute left. Nice run on the floor and put back by Watson.
Yeah, he does get them down.
I was talking to Stu Jackson earlier, and former coach, by the way, in the Big Ten at one time, Stu.
Sure. Now with Val, the commissioner Ackerman. Now with Val.
And he commented, as we did earlier, that Nate Watson reminds you of a Georgetown big when Big John was coaching.
Mm-hmm. Coffee left. You got to take the left.
Yeah. By the way, speaking of Big John, they've got a big coach there now.
Yeah, they do. And he got his congratulations to him, right? Yep. Got his first one.
And before we go off the air, Bill, I wanted to make mention of this because I know you knew Jeff Capel Jr. so well, as I did. And I know his son so well, Jeff, his son who coaches with Mike Krzyzewski at Duke, and Jason, who's now doing some broadcasting in the ACC. They lost him after a long bout with ALS. A wonderful man who loved the game, and Godspeed to all of the Capels.
Great, great, great guy. Got to know him years ago when he was with Bobby Stack. Nice man. Ended his career in the NBA, and both boys are treasures, too. So God bless them.
Edwards. 86-74 will not be indicative of how well this one was competed by both teams. And our congratulations to Richard Pitino and to Ed Cooley. Can't wait to see both of them develop.
Absolutely. Two hard-fought teams and left it all out there. Experience sort of won out.
They outscored Minnesota. This Providence team 40-23 in the last 14 minutes. There's our final, 86-74. For Bill Raftery, this is Tim Brando saying we will send you to Greg Wolf at Jim Jackson right after this. College Hoops is here. Stay right where you are.